Hey guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how you can install TensorFlow with GPU support for Windows operating system. So let's begin. So the first thing that we'll do is we'll install Anacondas. To install Anacondas, we'll go to this website. From here we'll download the installer for Windows. Once downloaded, you can follow these steps given on this website. I'll post all the links in the description. So can follow these instructions. You need to click on next and then you need to install it. If you want, you can tick this option as well, and once done, Anacondas will get installed. So to check if Anaconda has been installed, you need to click on Windows and type Anaconda. So Anaconda prompt will show up. So you need to just type Python. So you can see we are able to access Python. So now we are done. So the next thing that we'll do is we'll create a separate environment. So in order to do that, you need to again open the Anaconda prompt. Then you need to type conda create name, and you can give any name to the environment. So here you can give myenv, and Python is equal to whichever version of Python you want to install along with it. So say for example, if we want to install Python 3.7, so we can type Python 3.7 and then you can hit enter. So here you can give any name to the environment. This is the name of your environment. So for example, I'm giving the name OpenCVENV. Okay, so you can give any name to the environment. So once done, you need to hit enter. On hitting enter, it will show you the list of things that it will install along with it. Then it will ask if you want to proceed. Then you need to click Y and then hit enter again. So it will create a new environment for you. So once an environment is created, you can activate that environment by opening this Anaconda prompt and then typing activate whatever name you have given to your environment. So a new environment will open up, which you just created. So as I said earlier, you can give any name to your environment. So I had already created this environment, so hence I didn't create it again. Now the next thing that you need to do is install TensorFlow with GPU support. So previously TensorFlow had two versions, one without GPU and one with GPU. But now TensorFlow has only one version. So, and GPU is optional with it. So to install TensorFlow, you just need to simply type pip install TensorFlow and hit enter. Once you hit enter, it will install TensorFlow in this environment. Okay, so once TensorFlow is installed, now the next thing that you need to do is install all the GPU dependencies. For example, now if I open the Anaconda prompt and go into the same environment that we just created and where we install TensorFlow, here if I type Python, then here if I try to import TensorFlow, so here you can see it is giving us a warning saying that it is not able to load dynamic library of CUDA, and it is also stating that you don't have a GPU setup. So if you want to get rid of this error and warning and make TensorFlow use GPU on a system, so if you go to the website of TensorFlow GPU, it will show you a list of software requirements. So you need to have a CUDA toolkit 11.0, which requires a driver greater than 450. So now first we'll see if we have an updated driver or not. So in order to check that, we'll first open our NVIDIA control panel and we'll see which type of GPU we have. So you can click here on system information. Here you can see I have a GeForce MX 230. So you can download it from Nvidia's website as well, or you can directly open, type the name of that GPU in your system, and there is already an app pre-installed. On opening it, it will show you an option of drivers at the top left, and clicking it, so here you can see I have a 417.88 version, and we need to have greater than 450. So let's download it. So, to press on Express Installation. So, once the installation is complete, you can close it. And you can see we have the latest driver now. Now, the next thing that we need to install is the CUDA toolkit. So, for that, we'll again go to the software requirements and say that we need to install CUDA 11.0. Again, this depends on the version of TensorFlow that you are using. So as of the latest TensorFlow version 2.4, we need to install CUDA 11.0. so we'll go to this website, and from here we'll choose CUDA version, CUDA toolkit 11.0. here we need to select on Windows, Windows version 10, and then we need to select on this. You can also select on this if you have a good internet connection, but we'll go with this, and we'll just click on this. So once you have downloaded the file, you can double click on it. So now we have successfully installed NVIDIA CUDA toolkit. So we'll click on next. Now the next thing that you need to download is CODNN. So here you can see the CODNN that we are supposed to install is version 8.0.4 for version 11.0 CUDA toolkit. So we'll go over here and we'll search for the right correct version. So this is 8.0.4 for CUDA 11.0. So we can click over here. Then we can click over here. So we have successfully downloaded CUDNN. So let's extract it. Here we need to right click on extract here. So once extracted, you will get this kind of folder. So after you have installed CUDA toolkit, you need to open the environment variables and here you just need to check whether bin folder and the libbnvvp is in the path. So if once you install the CUDA toolkit, it should automatically come over here, but we need to just double check on it. Now once this is done, we can open the CUDA folder that we extracted from the CUDNN. Okay, and then again we need to go into the C drive, program files, NVIDIA GPU toolkit, and go in the bin folder. Now from the CUDA folder that we extracted from CUDNN, we need to go into the bin, copy all, and just paste it over here. Then again we need to go into the include, copy all, and paste it all. So now we have successfully configured a GPU. So to just verify it, we can open the Anaconda prompt and activate our environment. Then we'll start Python and then import TensorFlow as TF. Now you can see it is not giving us the error that it used to give earlier. So we have successfully configured TensorFlow with NVIDIA GPU. I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.